Hey, I'm going to continue my wolf head series, and this time we're going to draw a growling wolf. Scary. So, let's get to it.
Alright, so you've already guessed it already. We're going to start with a circle. Very simple. What's going on? Be quiet. And I'd like to make a dot in the middle for orientation. And this time we are going to make him look to the right. And the eye is about here. This is the middle. Okay, and we are drawing the snout at first. It's about this long. Again, we take the radius as a reference. Like this. Also, what we're going to do already is we flatten the circle a little bit, make it an oval shape right here, and also right down here. Like this. Okay, back to the snout, and we are going to draw the nose. Like this. This is where it starts, and we draw a little rectangle for the front of the nose. There it angles up a little bit. There we close it on the side. Okay, now let's give it a little bit more detail. Well, we are looking at it from almost completely to the side, and so it's positive perspective. The nostril on this side here is barely even visible, but on the other side it is. Like this. We start from the side here, make the circle. Alright, and we soften the edges a little bit, make it rounder. And from this point here, curve it, make it a little bit round too. And this is a basic shape for the nose. Now the next thing, let's do the eye. We are drawing a simple small circle again. And the inner eye corner, this dark part here. And because he's growling and seemingly angry, he will have his eyes widely opened. We use the full circle, and the pupils are very small. Makes him look even angrier. Oh my, don't mess with this one. I add some additional lines here to make his anger even more clear. Okay. And my God! Oh, Chris. Shh. Shh. What? Come here. Come here. Yes, my God. Going crazy. What is it? What is it? Little baby. Sorry, Hoko is going crazy again. Okay, let's get back to the drawing. Well, I'm drawing here a center line all the way to the nose. Bye bye, Hoko. And we need it for the folds on his nose bridge. Because he's angry and so everything is wrinkling up. And we make it, well, first of all, I'll make it this here. And then make these two lines here. Very simple. And now we're starting from the eye, very close to the eye. And this will be the first wrinkle. I normally make it into three sections. This is the first section, the first wrinkle. Now then we start from below the eye, all the way up here. This will be the second one, and a smaller one as the last one. And yeah, on the other side, same. It's coming together like this. Hoko, you are distracting me. My god. My. Yes, yes, I let you out. Wait. Sorry. Again, sorry. I think it won't take that long until she wants to get back inside. Oh. So, these were the wrinkles for the nose bridge in a very simple way here. and let's continue with the snout. Now, this time the mouth will be opened. So, we are drawing these curves here all the way down. Depending on how long these curves are, the wideness of the mouth is going to be determined how open it is, how widely open it is. Now, and we're drawing this curve here too again for the shape, and connect here. Alright, now we are having here this part. We start like here, and then we draw the line here all the way back to where the circle is. About here, we are going a little bit more steeply down, then turn around. And also back side here, going up a little bit. And normally when wolves are growling, they show their bare fangs and some of the teeth ridge. This is what we also need to show here. So I'll make some lines here, some dots for whiskers. Okay. And now let's get to the teeth. And the teeth are normally separated into four sections. At the front we have the incisors. We have six of those. And right behind it, not all the way at the front, are the canine. Here and here. And right at the back of it, we have the first, the premolars. I think two or three. And after that, we have the molars. And some of them are like a big bulk of tooth, I don't know. Okay, and pretty much the same on the other side too. So here we have canine again, the front incisors, the other canine, and normally lips are a little bit folding up like this at this point. And here we have the premolars, and further back we get to the molars, these big teeth. And we draw the tongue, a little bit curved here, stopping right here, and again premolars, and also the molars. looks a little bit messy, but I will clean it up later when doing the line art. Okay. And of course, we have to remind ourselves, they are not like glued on this teeth ridge, but they are rooted, and therefore we have to draw them accordingly, like this. It looks already much scarier, I would say. Okay, now let's get to the ears. For this I'm going to draw from here, from this corner here, a curve all the way back until we get to the top of the head, and make an intersecting line here. A little bit steeper, yes, like this. And this intersection here is one of the corners of the ears, of this ear, I mean. And this time we are bending the ear a little bit to the back, not all the way, we leave this for the next one, but just a little bit. Here it's pretty straight, and then let's say the other corner is here, and this is bending like this, very curved. And the other ear is about stuck in here, like this, curving down. All right. Now let's add some details. A little bit here in the ears, and some fur lines for the shape of the head. Very simple. Very quickly done. Okay. I also go down here and find the shape of the mouth a little bit more, of the jaw. Okay, and here the forehead too. Now, as often I want to emphasize, I want to define the shape of the eyes a little bit more by drawing these fur lines. I can hear Hokwe again. I guess she wants to get inside. Yeah, probably a lot of cat owners can relate. So here we have another wrinkle, and I want to make some additional lines for a little bit of, for the body, not too much, like this. That's fine, I don't need more. And let me see, but I think it's fine like this. Yeah. All right, so I will get to the outlining now, but before that I'm going to let Hokwe inside again.
Oh my.
Did you make some poopy? Or pee-pee?
You're a stinky butt. You're such a stinky butt. Stinky cat. Stinky. You're so stinky.
Eat it. Yeah. Yum. And she's inside again. Let's see for how long. Okay, so another thing that I wanted to tell you is a little bit about the Wu's bad reputation. Well, as you can already see in this picture, he's very scary and people fear the Wu. And especially you know it from the old stories that Wu's are portrayed as the baddest evil guys. Like in stories like Little Red Riding Hood or The Three Little Pigs. Or the boy who cried wolf, you know, these kind of stories. And well, people back then just didn't know better. Because wolves normally just run away when they see people, and
so they don't know anything about them other than they look scary with the bared fangs, you know, like just raw. And they hear the howls in late at night, which gave them shivers. And also they are annoying and they are hated because they kill the livestock. And this is why the wolves have such a bad reputation and many people want them to be killed. But as I said before, wolves are actually not that dangerous. I mean, they kill livestock, but they normally wouldn't go after us. This is a completely irrational fear. There are so few cases where wolves actually attacked people, and mostly it was due rabies or they were provoked. What's very frustrating to me is that even nowadays wolves are still portrayed as the bad, as the evil guys in some stories. And especially in video games, you know, in RPG games, one of the first enemies you're going to fight will probably some sort of wolf or some bear, I don't know. Even though they are not dangerous at all in reality. But hey, they have this bad reputation anyway, so it's easy to use. Yeah, so I'm going to fast forward now until I'm done and get back to you. Alright. Okay, I'm done. This one is probably a little bit more complicated, so don't be discouraged if you don't succeed at the first try. I know the teeth and the open mouth is not easy to draw. I hope that my tutorial made it at least a little bit easier for you. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, feedback or requests from me, then as always, please let me know in the comment section. Okay then. Have fun drawing.